Hi, today we're going to demonstrate the termination of our half-inch air dielectric, our LPA 500 LLPL cable. This is commonly used as a feeder cable in building feeder cable. It's a low loss cable. It's listed, plenum listed, UL plenum listed. Very easy to terminate. We're going to demonstrate that right now. We have our prep tool here, our ST LPA 500. We have EZ 500 LP connector. It's an EZ style connector that's going to be snapped onto this cable. This prep tool here can be used by hand or it can be used in a drill. We're going to mount it in a drill. We'll just take an Allen wrench here and take that handle right off, like so. Pop that into the drill, like that. We're all ready to go. And before we even get started, what we're going to do here, there's annular corrugations in this cable, as you can see. And we want to make the cable cut on a high spot of those corrugations. So you can see the corrugations through the jacket. I'm just going to make a little mark with a pen, just like that. We're going to take our CCT O2 cutting tool. We're going to line that right up with that mark we just made, like so. And we're going to spin this around the cable. And just let the blade do the work. We'll scribe the center conductor. It'll snap just like that. Now we'll take our tool, place it over the cable, and just... Now this tool actually has three blades in it. So what we've done there is we've stripped back and exposed the center conductor, stripped back the jacket, and deburred the center conductor. There's a little bit of residual plastic on there, so we'll take a safety razor, just a razor there, and just gently run it right around the face of the dielectric, like so. Then that should peel right off. And now you have a perfectly prepped cable. We'll take our back end, place that onto the cable like so. Just like that. You see a little bit of the copper corrugation protruding beyond that back end there. Now we'll take our FT1250 flaring tool. That'll locate right on the center conductor and just run this right around the circumference of the cable like so. That'll flare that out just a little bit. Now that back piece is not going anywhere. It's locked onto the cable. The front end has a beryllium copper, silver plated beryllium copper spring finger contact in it. That just pops right onto the center conductor like so. That'll thread right together. And at this point, all you would do is take a couple 13 millimeter wrenches, open end wrenches, and you would just tighten that right up and you're good to go. Thank you.